My name is M. Haimavati. I am working as a TGT Mathematics in APR School, Mayanar Tigers, Chittoor. I think you have already learned about the integers in previous sessions. Now I am going to tell about properties of integers. As all of you know, the integers are denoted by the letter Z. We are familiar with the properties, the names of the properties that are closure, associative, identity, commutative. Why? Because we have already learned the properties like closure, associative, etc. on whole numbers in 6th classes. Now, we will see the properties one by one. The first property is closure property. We are going to check the closure property with respect to addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Just I am writing the rule with respect to addition. If a comma b are integers, then the operation performed, that means a plus b, should also be an integer. Then we can say that it follows the closure property. So I am taking two integers, 5 plus of minus 4 is equal to 5 plus into minus minus 5 minus 4 1. Here 5 is an integer, minus 4 is also an integer. The resultant 1 is also an integer. So what we can conclude? We can conclude that integers are closed with respect to addition. Integers are closed with respect to addition. Now I am going to subtraction. 5 minus of minus 4 is equal to 5 plus 4. What is the value of 5 plus 4? 9. That is also belongs to Z. Here 5 is an integer and 4 is an integer. The addition, the subtraction, the resultant 9 is also an integer. So what we can conclude? We can conclude that integers are closed under subtraction. Integers are closed under subtraction. Now I am moving to multiplication. 5 into minus 4. 5 fours are 20 plus into minus minus. Here minus 20 is also an integer. So what we can conclude again? We can say that integers are closed under multiplication. Now it is the turn to check whether the division of integers follows closure property or not. Just I will check. 5 divided by minus 4. Clearly we can say this is not an integer. This is not an integer. So the integers are not closed under division. So I am explaining again. Integers are closed under addition, subtraction, multiplication, but not under division. This is the first property. Now I am going to explain about the second property, that is commutative property. Second one is commutative property. Similarly, as we done the closure property, we check one by one, that is commutative property under addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Just I am writing the rule with respect to addition. If a comma b belongs to Z, a plus b is equal to b plus a. If we change the position of the integers, the operation performed earlier should be equal. So I am taking the two integers, 3 plus of minus 2. 3 minus 2 means 1. I am changing the position of minus 2 and 3. Minus 2 plus 3. That is equal to 1. The result is same. Therefore, integers follow commutative property under addition. Now I am moving to subtraction. 3 minus of minus 2 is equal to 3 plus 2. That is equal to 5. Minus 2 and minus 3. That is minus 5, but both are not equal. Therefore, commutative property is not true in the case of subtraction of integers. And next I am moving to multiplication. 3 into minus 2 is equal to minus 6. And again I am changing the position of the integers. Minus 2 into 3. That is also minus 6. The result is same. Therefore, the integers follow commutative property with respect to multiplication. But now we will check about division. 3 divided by minus 2 is not equal to minus 2 divided by 3 clearly. So, commutative property is not true in case of division of integers. So, what we can conclude? Integers are follow commutative property with respect to addition and multiplication. With respect to addition and multiplication. And again, I am going to explain about associative property of integers. Associative property of integers. Associative property. Alright, we check with respect to addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. I am writing the rule with respect to addition. A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. See here, 3 plus of 2 minus 4. That is 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. 3 plus 2 minus 4 is equal to 5 minus 4 is equal to 1. The result is same. So, integers follow associative property with respect to addition. With respect to addition. Now, I am moving to subtraction. 3 minus 2 minus of minus 4 is equal to 3 minus minus of minus plus. So, 2 plus 4 is 6. That is equal to 3 minus 6 minus 3. Similarly, I am taking the LHS. 3 minus 2 minus of minus 4. 3 minus 2 is 1. Minus into minus plus 5. That is equal to 6. The result is not same. Therefore, associative property is not in subtraction of integers. Now in the case of multiplication, 3 into 2 into minus 4 is equal to 6 into minus 4. That is 6 fours are 24, minus 20. Similarly, 3 into 2 into minus 4 is equal to 3 into minus 8. 8 threes are or 3 eights are 24. Minus is there, so it is also minus 24. So, minus 24 and minus 24 are equal. So, what we can conclude? The integers follow associative property with respect to multiplication. Follow associative property with respect to multiplication. Now, it is the turn to check in division. See here. 3 divided by 4. Divided by 4, that is 3 by 2 by 4 by 1 is equal to 3 by 2 into 1 by 4 is 3 by 8. Similarly, 3 divided by 2 divided by 4, that is 3 by 2 by 4, that is equal to 2 ones are 2 twos are 6. Here the result is not same. Therefore, associative property does not hold under division. So, in associative property of integers is true in case of addition. Sorry, here not subtraction, addition and multiplication. So, associative property is true in the case of addition and multiplication. Now, I am moving to the next property, that is nothing but identity. Identity of integers, that is additive identity. Next property is additive identity. Identity is nothing but me. I am the identity of Haimavati. So here 2 is. The identity of 2 is 2. So to get 2, what should we add to 2? 0. Similarly, minus 4 plus dash is equal to minus 4. Minus 4 is the identity of minus 4. So what we have to add here? 0. So this 0 is called the additive identity of integers. So 0 is called additive identity. Similarly, in case of multiplication, 2 into dash is equal to 2. From, by which number should be multiplied to get to 1? Similarly, minus 4 into dash is equal to minus 4. Here is also 1. This 1 is called multiplication identity. This 1 is called multiplicative identity. So 0 is called additive identity and 1 is called the multiplicative identity of integers. And now next property, additive inverse. See, 2 plus dash is equal to 0. What we have to add to 2 to get 0? Minus 2. So here, minus 2 is called additive inverse of 2. Similarly, we can call 2 as additive inverse of minus 2. Minus 2 is additive inverse of 2 and 2 is additive inverse of minus 2. Similarly, next property. And last and final property, that is distributive property. That is A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. I am distributing A to B and C. So we can remind like that. This is the distributive property. I am distributing A to B and then A to C. For example, A is equal to 3, B is equal to 2, C is equal to minus 2. See, 3 into 0. So I am taking another 2. Explain it properly. Minus 4. 2 minus 4. That is equal to 3 into minus 2 is minus 6. Similarly, A into B means 3 into 2 plus A into C, 3 into minus 4, that is 6 minus 12, that is equal to minus 6. So this is called distributive property. So these are the properties of integers. I conclude this class with a single table. Just see, closure, commutative, associative, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. In this class we have learned the property that closure property of integers is true in case of addition, subtraction, multiplication, but not true in case of division. Similarly, commutative property is true in case of addition and multiplication, but not subtraction and division. Associative property, this is also true in case of addition and multiplication, but not in the case of subtraction and division. Identity, additive identity. Additive identity is 0. Multiplicative identity is 1. These are the terms we have learned here. In next session, I will view the worksheets on these properties. I think children, all of you understand this very easily as because we have already learned the operation of integer. So it is very easy to remember and learn. Thank you children. Stay home and stay safe. See the multiplication of two or more negative numbers. Minus 1 into minus 1. 1 into 1, 1. Minus into minus, plus. Now I am taking 3 times. Minus into minus, plus. Plus into minus, minus 1. And again, minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. Minus into minus, plus. Plus into minus, minus. Again minus into minus, plus. So, minus into minus, plus. Plus into minus, minus. Minus into plus, minus. Plus into plus, plus. So, similarly, I am taking minus 1 5 times. Minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. So how many times I am multiplying minus 1? 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Minus into minus. Plus. Plus into minus. Minus. Minus into minus. Plus. Plus into minus. Minus. So observe here. I am multiplying minus 1 2 times. Here 3 times. 4 times. And 5 times. If you observe, the product of negative numbers when multiplied even number of times, you are getting positive number. You are getting positive. If you multiply two or more negative numbers odd number of times, you are getting negative. So, the product of negative numbers when multiplied even number of times, we get positive symbol. If we multiply the product of numbers odd number of times, we get negative symbol. So, if we multiply the product of, or if we multiply the negative numbers even number of times, we get positive symbol. If we multiply negative numbers odd number of times, we will get negative. Now we will see an example problem about associative problem. Multiply using associative law. See here, minus 25 into minus 4 into minus 2 into minus 8. See here, what is minus into minus? Plus. 25 fours are 100 into 2 into minus 8. 100 into 2? 200 into minus 8. Plus into minus. Minus 200 into 8, 1600. So we are using associative law to simplify the calculation. Again, we will see another example. See here, minus 20 into minus 2 into minus 5 into 7. Minus 20 into minus, plus 2 5s of 10 into 7. Plus 10. So minus 20 into minus plus 10 is minus 200 into 7. That is nothing but minus 1400. 7 zeros are 0. 7 zeros are 0. And 7 twos are 14. And symbol is minus. So I am putting minus in front of 1400. Now we will check this question. Check whether minus 42 into minus 7 and minus 7 into 42 are equal. Write the law. See here, minus 42 into minus 7. Minus into minus, plus. 7 twos are 14. 4. 7 fours are 28 plus 1, 29. So, 42 minus 42 into minus 7 is plus 294. Now I am multiplying minus 7 into minus 40. So this is also equals to, see here, 7 2s are 14, 1, 7 4s are 28, 29. See, minus 40. See here, 2 7s are 14, 2 7s are 28. That is nothing but 294. Therefore, the answer is same. Therefore, minus 42 into minus 7 is equal. to minus 42. A into B is equal to B into A. The answer is same when you multiply A into B or B into A. This is nothing but commutative law. What is this? Commutative law. We change the position of A and B, the resultant should be same. So here minus 42 into minus 7 is equal to minus 7 into minus 42. Find the loss. So minus 3 plus 5 is equal to 5 plus minus 3. See here the symbols are different. So we have to subtract. 5 minus 3 is 2. Here 5 plus into minus. Plus into minus is minus. Therefore 5 minus 3. What is 5 minus 3? 2. What is this law? A plus B is equal to B plus A for A comma B or integers. So this is commutative law. What do you call this law? Commutative. Here we are adding. So it is under addition. Therefore additive commutative law. Let us see the second one. Minus 2 into 1 is equal to minus 1 into minus 2 is equal to minus 2. Here we are getting the identity minus 2 when multiplied by 1. This is called multiplicative identity. Here 1 is called multiplicative identity. Second one is multiplicative identity. Let us move to third problem. See here, minus 5 into 2, minus 10 into 3. That is equal to minus 30. See here, all H's, minus 5 into 3 2's are 6. 6 5's are 30. The symbol is minus, so we are putting minus. So minus 30 is equal to minus 30. So it is associative law under multiplication. So associative law. That is A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. So this is associative law. And coming to the problem number 4. See here, what are we doing here? 18 into 7 plus of minus 3 is equal to 18 into 7 plus 18 into minus 3. We are distributing 18 into 7 as well as minus 3. So we are distributing 18 into, this is distributive law. This is distributive law. 18 into 7 plus of minus 3 means minus. 7 minus 3 is 4. That is 18 fours are 72. Here 18 sevens are, how much 18 sevens are? 126 minus 18 threes are 54. That is also equal to 70. This is what, which law this is? This is distributive law. Distributive law. See here, next problem. Minus 5 into 6 is equal to minus 30. I will remind you, I will recall that is, if A and B are integers, then A into B is also an integer. What will you say? We will say that it is closed under multiplication. It is closed under multiplication. So what is this law? Closure. Closure law or closure property. Do you understand this? A into B belongs to A. A comma B belongs to Z. A into B is also belongs to Z, means it is closure property or closure law. And coming to the next problem. Minus 3 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus minus 3 is equal to minus 3. Here we are adding 0 to minus 3 to get minus 3. That means identity. You are getting the identity of minus 3 by 0. Therefore, 0 is additive identity. So, what is the property here used? Additive identity. See here, we have already learned the properties and have learned the examples. I'm moving to the next problem. What is the second problem in the exercise? See the question first. What will be the sign of product? 24 times a negative number. 24 times a negative number. We have already learned earlier that if we multiply the numbers even number of times, then we multiply the negative numbers even number of times, what will you get? Positive number. What will you get? Positive. So this is positive. Which type of number is 35? 35 is an odd number. So here we are multiplying negative numbers how many times? 35 times. That is odd number of times. So what will be the sign of the resultant? The resultant should be negative. So resultant should be negative. See what is the question given here? Write the numbers in the primes by using appropriate law. See here, minus 3 plus dash is equal to minus 3. Here, minus 3 is the identity of minus 3. See here, when you get minus 3, when you get minus 3, what should be added to minus 3 here? Observe here, a plus 0 is equal to a. Therefore, what is the answer here? 0. So, minus 3 plus 0 is equal to minus 3. And moving to the second question. 2 into minus 3 is equal to minus 3 into dash. If we resemble these as A into B is equal to B into dash. So, see here, where is that? A into B is equal to B into dash means A. So, what is A here? A into B, what is the value of A? 2. So, what is the answer here? 2. See here, minus 6. Plus of 3 plus of minus 2 is equal to, so here minus 6 plus dash, so minus 6 plus 3 and again plus of minus 2. So what is this now? Here, come here, moving to the associate law. A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. So this is associative law. See here we have added to get the identity minus 6. In this example or in this problem, what should we multiply minus 6 to get minus 6? See here, what is the identity in multiplicative identity? 1. So when you multiply minus 6 by 1, we get minus 6. So what is this now? Multiplicative identity. And see the next problem. 5 into minus 6 plus 9. 5 into minus 6 plus 9. See here, this is in the form of A into B plus C. A into B plus C. What is the answer? AB plus AC. That means A into B plus A into C. A into B plus C means A into B. So what is the value of A? 5. So 5 into minus 6 plus A into C. So the value of A is given into C. What is the value of C here? 9. Therefore 5 into 9. So if you understand the properties of integers, we can answer this very easily. Next question. State true or false, give reasons. State true or false and give reasons. 2 is multiplicative identity of minus 2. Is it correct? No. Why? Because to get to what should be multiplied to 1. So this is true and this is not true. So it is false. the next question. Integers are commutative under subtraction? No. See here. Under subtraction, integers does not follow the commutative law. Therefore, this is also false. This is also false. See here. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. Minus 3. Minus 2 is minus 1. It's not equal. Therefore, this is not commutative under subtraction. Next. True or false? Give state true or false and give reasons. See here, what is given? 2 is multiplicative identity of minus 2. No, because 2 get 2, we have to multiply by 1. So it is false. See here, what is the second one? Integers are commutative under subtraction. Integers are commutative under subtraction. See here, no. This is also false. See here, I am taking two integers, 2 and minus a minus b. 2 into minus into minus plus 2 plus 3, 5. And again I am taking b minus a. So b minus a, that is minus 5. So 5 is not equal to minus 5. Therefore, integers are not commutative under subtraction. And see the third one. For any integers a and b, a into b is equal to b into a. For any integers a and b, a into b is equal to b into a. So coming to this table, we can easily identify the commutative law on the multiplication is true. Therefore, a into b is equal to b into a. Therefore, this is true. And next one. Division of integer by 0 is not defined. As all of you know, up to now, the division by 0 is not defined. Therefore, division of integers is also not defined. So, it is true. What is the next question? Simplify the following using suitable law. See, minus 11 into minus 25 into minus 4. We can multiply directly, but it takes some more time. To make easily, we can apply the laws. See here, I am applying association law. Applying here association. See, minus 11 into minus 25 into minus 4. So, minus 11 into minus into minus plus 25 fourths of 100. So, 11 hundredths of 11 hundred plus into minus minus. So, it is very easy to calculate and we use the property. We can also directly multiply, but when it is when we apply the law, it is easy. And one more example. See here, 3 into minus 18 plus 3 into minus 7. By observing this, we can know that 3 is in the two terms, that is a into b plus a into c is equal to a into b plus c. Distributive law. That is equal to 3 into minus 18 plus of minus 32. That is equal to 3 into plus into minus minus. Therefore, minus 18 and minus 32 is minus 15. That is equal to 53 of 150 plus into minus minus. What is this law? This is distributive law. This is distributive law. Okay, I will meet you in next class. I will explain Bodmer's rule in next coming section. Thank you children. Stay home and stay safe.